Let's discuss the production of continuous X-rays. As we already discussed that in collision tube from a cathode, when fast moving electrons are emitted, this is because of electrically heated cathode. There is a heater connected in a close vicinity of cathode due to which electrons are emitted by thermionic emission from the cathode. And because of high potential difference, when these electrons reach the anode, X-rays are emitted from the anode when these electrons collide. Now we are going to discuss about the production mechanism of continuous X-rays. These are called continuous X-rays because the X-rays emitted from the cathode have a wavelength range varying from a minimum value to very high values. And as all wavelengths are present, that's why the spectrum of these X-rays is continuous, and hence these are called continuous X-rays. This is the reason, because all wavelengths are present, these X-rays are also called white X-rays. Now, just to understand the production mechanism, let's have a look on this picture, which is an atom of this anode material. And as we already discussed, that anode is made up of quite a heavy metal. That's why we can see that most of the inner orbits are completely filled with the electrons, because its atomic number is very high. And here we can see, if an external cathode ray electron comes and collide with the anode, and when it penetrates into the anode atom, and if it does not collide with any of the orbiting electron, and when it comes close to the nucleus, it will experience a very high electrostatic attraction by the nucleus, and due to a very high acceleration, the electron will lose the electromagnetic radiation in the surrounding, which are actually the X-rays, and this is the way how these X-rays are produced. And we can see in this situation, according to Maxwell's theory, we know that a charged particle, whenever accelerated, it loses its kinetic energy in form of electromagnetic radiations. So in this situation, the kinetic energy of a cathode ray electron can be simply written as EV, where V is the potential difference applied across the discharge tube, and maximum electron can lose its total kinetic energy. So if this kinetic energy is lost in form of an electromagnetic photon, it can be written as HC by lambda, and this is the maximum energy of X-ray photon which can be emitted by this cathode ray electron. And here you can see, if the electron is slightly away from the nucleus, the energy release will be relatively less, because it will experience less acceleration. So in this situation, this will correspond to the minimum wavelength emitted of X-rays by the electron. This will be HC by EV, and here HC and E are constants. We substitute the values, the value of minimum wavelength will be 12431 by V in angstrom. This we already studied. And this minimum possible wavelength of X-rays which are emitted from the discharge tube depends on the potential difference applied, and it is called cutoff wavelength of continuous X-rays emitted. And this is the way how X-rays are emitted. Once again, I repeat, if electron is not very close to the nucleus in this situation, and it is relatively away from the nucleus, due to less attraction and acceleration, the wavelength emitted will be relatively more. That's why almost all wavelength above a minimum cutoff wavelength are present in the production of continuous X-rays. As we have discussed on the previous sheet, that from X-ray tube, X-rays are emitted in range from lambda C to infinity, where lambda C was the cutoff wavelength, and here lambda C can be given, as we have just now calculated, 12431 by V angstrom. And here we can see that by varying the value of potential difference across the discharge tube, the cutoff wavelength can be changed. Correspondingly, the overall range in which the X-rays are emitted will get changed. And here we can see that X-rays are emitted in the range from lambda C to infinity, which we can also call as continuous wavelength distribution. And due to this only we can state, when we plot the variation graph of intensity of X-rays emitted with the wavelength of X-rays, looks like a continuous spectrum. That's why such X-rays are called continuous X-rays, or these are also called white X-rays. White X-rays because the wavelength is distributed between a minimum value to a very large ranges. On the next sheet, we'll discuss the wavelength spectrum of continuous X-rays, in which we'll study the variation of spectral intensity with the wavelength distribution. Let us discuss the spectrum of continuous X-rays. Here in the spectrum, we are going to discuss the variation of spectral intensity with wavelength of emitted X-rays. Now, if we just have a look on the picture, this picture gives you an idea about how the wavelength variation causes change in a spectral intensity. In this picture, you can see that at different voltages, when we plot the graph of spectral intensity with the wavelength and corresponding to a specified wavelength, this graph gives us an idea about how this intensity varies. We can see that all these graphs look similar to each other, but stretched on the scale in y direction. And here these are the points which are cutoff wavelengths corresponding to various wavelengths. And we can see almost at all wavelengths some spectral intensity is present. That's why this spectrum is known as continuous spectrum. And this is the actual shape of continuous X-ray spectrum.